Most of the time, when we have a system of equations, we are concerned about finding a solution to it. So it's natural to ask the question, do all systems have a solution? Let's find out. Let's look at a typical type of system that you might see in a problem. Let's say y equals negative 2x plus 10 and y equals x minus 5. There's two equations, that's our system. We can get a sense for the solutions to this system if we draw a sketch of the graphs. For the first one, y equals negative 2x plus 10, we have a positive slope and a negative y-intercept, which will look something like this. And for the second equation, y equals x minus 5, we have a negative y-intercept and a positive slope, which will look something like this. Now, how many solutions does this system have? Well, a solution corresponds to a point of intersection of the graphs. We see one right here, and so we know this system has at least one solution. Is it possible that it could have more? Another solution would correspond to another intersection of the two graphs, but since these graphs are lines, they can't intersect again. The first line is always going to be going down in this direction. The second line is always going to be going up in this direction. They will never curve back and meet each other again. This kind of a system has exactly one solution, and it is called consistent and independent. Now let's look at another system to see another possibility. Let's take the system y equals x plus 5 and y equals x minus 5. The important thing to note here is that these graphs are parallel. They have the same slope, positive 1. And so when we graph them, one has a positive y-intercept, and the other has a negative y-intercept, but they run in the same direction. They're parallel. So what does that mean about their solution? A solution would correspond to a point of intersection. Parallel lines never intersect. And so what we would conclude in this case is that this system has no solution. A system that has no solution is called inconsistent. There's one last possibility to examine, and so let's look at an example. Suppose we take y equals x minus 5 as our first equation. And then for our second equation, we also choose y equals x minus 5. What will the picture look like in this case? Well, when we graph the first line, we see it has a positive slope and a negative y-intercept, so it will look like this. And then when we graph the second line, we see that it has the exact same slope and the exact same y-intercept, and so it's going to lie right on top of the first line. So what does that mean about the solutions to the system? Well, a solution corresponds to a point of intersection of the two lines. Since these lines lie right on top of each other, they intersect at every single point. That's an infinite number of intersection points. Therefore, this system has an infinite number of solutions. The term for this type of system is dependent.